Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear.
Let's talk about it. It should be a time of remembering what Jesus Christ has done for us. So if you're welcome to sing along with me, if you don't want to sing, that's okay. But as we think about the Lord's Supper this morning, I do want to go to the Lord in prayer for the needs that are listed in the bulletin. Continue to keep Janet Whitkey in your prayers. Some additional names that we can add, Jean, the John Gary family, G-E-A-R-Y, and also the Mercy Ernest family. So we grieve with these families. We can probably remove in the first column down toward the bottom about fourth of the way from the bottom, Garland Freeman. Garland is doing well, and thank the Lord they never came up with any explanation of why he was getting swelling in his joints, but he said that he's doing better, so we thank the Lord for his progress. We can add to our prayer list Kevin Collins, Mary Collins' son. He's going to have a colonoscopy and an endoscopy this week, and we pray that he gets good information. Donna Schoolcraft is a little under the weather this morning, so we pray that she's going to get better. Diane Schoolcraft, she had her back spinal fusion this past week, and so she's having to learn to walk, and said that she's making progress, so we just pray for her continued recovery. Tyler Smith, Franny Smith's son, got an infection in his eye, got a piece of metal in his eye, and she has prayer for him. And then I've put down Joyce Miles, praying that she doesn't have an infection and need another surgery. So keeping her in prayer. Maybe there are additional names or needs that you'd like to mention. Anybody?
Faye Schaefer.
What was that?
Faye Schaefer has pneumonia.
Faye Schaefer has pneumonia, okay. Faye Schaefer. And I was also supposed to give each one of y'all a greeting from Dorothy Schaefer down in Florida. She's doing well. She's only wearing her oxygen at night, and she told her daughter, she confessed on the phone, that sometimes she doesn't even wear it at night. And her daughter said, well, why are you taking it out, Mom? She says, because I don't like messing around that cord. So Dorothy Schaefer will be back next month, and in May she will be 98 years of age. So we're grateful for her progress. Also, I think I was supposed to tell you that either this week or last week that Heather Ferguson said to say hello to everybody. She's out in Colorado. So are there additional names or needs? Yes, Ms. Andre.
We have Lori Williamson on the prayer list.
Her strokes?
It's actually Wilkerson.
Okay.
And she is born on the 16th for that gamma surgery that I told you guys about a month ago.
Okay.
So we should have some more news here in the next couple weeks on her. She has the tumors in her brain.
Okay, about halfway down the second column, Jean, Lori, instead of Williamson, it should be Wilkerson. And on the 16th, she's going to have gamma surgery. But she had had some strokes.
Yes.
Yes. So we pray that that's going to go well for her on the 16th. Are there any other updates or prayer needs? Well, let's join our hearts together for prayer. Father, we've come into your house today and grateful that we can be here. I said it last week and I'll say it again. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Father, we come into your house, and it's a reminder to us that you are still God. You always have been, you always will be, and you are in charge. We thank you, Father, that even though things may not be well in our world or what's going on within our lives, you still rule and reign no matter what. And we thank you, Father, that you do have something better prepared, that we just need to keep our eyes focused upon you. So we come in your house today, grateful that we can be here, grateful we have this place to worship in, and grateful too, Father, for all that you've done for us this past week. Thankful for the many ways that you've shown your love for us, whether it's the health that you've given us, the food that you've given us, the safety that you've given us, Father, the family, jobs. There was so much that we could say thank you for, but we thank you more than anything that you gave us your Son, Jesus Christ. We've come today, as we always do, to bring honor and glory to the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus Christ, your Son. And so we come today, Father, to not only praise you and to thank you, but to come before you with our needs. And Father, the ones we've got listed in the bulletin are a small portion of the needs that we're aware of. I've oftentimes thought, Father, I can't imagine what it would be like for you that knows everything about everybody. And yet, Father, you do. People say, well, then why do we need to pray if God already knows us, knows about these needs? And you've taught us, Father, that we really need to. Your Son taught us to pray, and he did by his own example, said that many times during the course of his ministry, he would slip off by himself and spend all night in prayer. And Father, it was an example that was set for us because we need to be reminded that we need you. We need your help. We need your blessings. And Father, we need to seek your will within our lives. Because Father, without you, we are nothing. So in some ways, I guess you could say prayer keeps us connected with you. That Father is a reminder to us that we desperately need you. And we bring these requests to this morning. Father, we're asking for your blessing to be upon all of these people. Father, we want the best for them. We also want your name to be magnified, that as people see your hand at work, they might come to recognize that you do care about people and you are involved in people's lives. We do continue to pray especially for Janet, and we ask you, Lord, to please touch her and heal her. And pray, Father, that you bless Clyde and the family as well. But there are others that we've got on our prayer list, even like this one that Ms. Audrey mentioned, Lori Wilkerson, who's already suffered some strokes and is facing a gamma knife procedure on the 16th. We pray that that's going to go well. But Father, there are just a lot of needs on our prayer list today, and we bring those to you and ask you, Father, to meet those needs. And may the people that experience a touch from your hand give glory to you and And may those that see your hand at work be amazed at what you're able to do, and may they turn to you in faith. We pray too, Father, for unspoken needs. Oftentimes there are things going on within our lives that we don't talk about with others, and we ask that you would help us with those areas in our lives as well. We do pray for our country. We pray that there can be a turning back to you. We have been encouraged to hear that there are pockets of revival around the country, and we pray, Father, that there might be even more of this because, Father, our country has definitely turned away from you, and we need to turn back to you. We pray for, with our churches, Father, that there would be a definite revival, a turning back not only to you, but to what your word teaches. And we pray, Father, that we might repent of the ways in which we've turned away from you and understand, Father, that we cannot expect your blessings if we are disobedient. We do pray, Father, for the lost that are around us, that, Lord, your spirit might speak to them. And we pray that you might give us, as Christians, a burden for them that we might encourage them to turn their hearts over to you. We do pray, Father, for our military and law enforcement, that you would bless them and keep them safe. And we pray, Father, too, that you might bless the remainder of this service today as we have an opportunity to look at what your word says, that you might speak to our hearts. Bless, Father, not only the service here in front, but also the service in back with the little church. And pray, Father, this might be a time that we turn our hearts towards you, that you might speak through our hearts and help us to grow to become more like your Son. Thank you for being our Father. Thank you so much for all that you do for us. Thank you for hearing our prayers. Bless now this prayer and use it for your glory and us for your service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.